Proof that I read your comments is recently on my Kershaw Emerson review, a good sub, the Broberst 1986, commented that the Yojimbo 2, which I recommended, had potential, but the Bacall's philosophy is a little bit more solid. That comment convinced me to want to take a deeper look at these two knives, both being marketed for the role of self-defense. So this will be a four-point comparison review of the Spyderco Yojimbo 2 and the Bacall. Now I'll be evaluating these based on their deployment, ergonomics, blade, in each category, then wrapping up with my final thoughts about their usability in real situations. First, thumbs up for both being made in the US, and that's because YouTube supplies reviewers with data which shows that 9% of the YouTube community for knives is primarily here in the States. So both these knives support the knife community and their respective designers. Both knives use peel-ply G10 that feels equally grippy. Both have skeletonized liners, and so the weight on both is comparable and not very cumbersome at all. Bacall has a steel ball lock mechanism, and it's not ceramic or plastic like on a Spyderco Dodo, but the compression lock is much faster and easier to open and close. For talking durability, the steel ball lock should hold up and last longer than the compressed liner, which I've shown the results in my test videos. If you're imagining the feel of the Bacall from owning the Pair 2 or holding the Yojimbo 2, it's different. The slightly wider handle makes it feel more sturdy than pictures show, and it also makes it easier for you to hold the knife and deploy it. You have more to grab. The second thing is the wire pocket clip, which kind of makes us think that it's less than preferable compared to the Yojimbo 2's solid design, and does kind of make the knife look in pictures like a featherweight for EDC, but it's actually stiffer and seems to be stronger than normal pocket clips, for example, on other Spyderco's. When closed, both knives have the same overall feeling of security in hand because of the G10. The Yojimbo 2 has ergonomic design on the blade, and because of the bottom taper and that thicker blade also stock, it feels more secure. The wave rod on the Bacall could hurt if you were to grab it and strike with the pommel in these directions. When open, the Bacall does feel more comfortable because of the larger bevels. And again, I said more width. You can see the bevel on these Pair 2s and even these Yojimbos. It's more just a rounding off in the sense of that corner. But on the Bacall, you actually get a nice bevel going around the knife. You can see the hardware of the Yojimbo 2 is larger than these smaller screws in the locking mechanism area of the Bacall. But the Bacall's back screw is actually the same size, similar to the pivot. And so both in most respects are equally rigid. With the Bacall you have the solid spacer, and then you have this wider back spacer. And with the Yojimbo 2 you have the nested steel liners, so it's kind of like only two halves rather than four pieces. Both different, but going to be equally strong. The Yojimbo 2 has a thicker blade overall, but the tip is actually thinner. Also, because the Yojimbo 2 is a sort of high hollow ground saber, and the Bacall is a full flat grind, the Bacall actually feels more strong, but the Yojimbo has proven its abilities to do a variety of cutting tasks on camera. So function-wise, the CPMS 30V in both blades can handle the grinds for all purpose. Proposed roles the Yojimbo is thought to do. The Bacall is set to take advantage of the wave feature, but a person can choose whether to go into reverse grip by deploying forward or having it situated this way in your perhaps your right pocket and deploying rearward and going into a forward grip with either left or right hand. Regular thumb deployment always has a sort of constant taut feeling because of that ball lock. You can see it doesn't swing freely. Thumb flicking, I don't think is going to work. And index finger flicking, you're going to have to give it a really forceful flick. And you can see because of the design of this knife, there's a sort of longer distance your thumb has to travel. And you kind of have to get used to that. It takes a little practice, and it isn't really extremely natural feeling. The Yojimbo 2 is nice here because it has four pocket clip positions. But that mainly means still tip up or tip down for each side, which equals then the Bacall's two options, a forward or rearward deploying for each hand. So both give you two choices, left or right hand. Spidey hole on both are the same size. Spy hole and both are the same size. But the Bacall's is more accessible because it's more properly spaced. And Yojimbo 2 has been dinging before about this, that the G10 scale kind of covers the hole. But the Yojimbo 2 has that built-in pivot spacer, much like on the Para 2. So the action is smooth. You can thumb flick it, index finger flick it. You can, you know, generally speaking, you have a variety of options. And if you want, you can do a dedicated grabby shake. And a person, if they want to, could take this further and actually grind off this portion of blade and create a wave. And then this entire view would be different. Ergonomically, the Bacall has a larger tail portion, so it's easier to grab the knife. And that's one of the weaknesses that the Yojimbo has had, which is the tail end is very narrow. So it depends. It can lead to missed attempts, especially in a dynamic situation, or if your pockets have a large ribbing or they're very thick. And you, when you try to pull, this clip is very strong. Thankfully, both aren't too deep of a carry. And both have a safety portion that's sort of built into the choil, so that if it were to disengage the lock, it wouldn't immediately cut your finger. But the choil on the Bacall is a little bit more like an actual circular choil. So doing that feels much safer than on the Yojimbo 2 doing that. Grip-wise, the Bacall has a thicker feel, which reminds me of Emerson's or other classical tactical knives, and like Trezula's, and that's because the liners aren't inset, and there's a solid space up front, and of course, dual G10. So if you prefer Emerson's, then the Bacall will feel very comfortable and remind you of those knives. I do personally prefer this more traditional, kind of stick-like shape, you know, that feels manipulable. The Yojimbo 2 follows that newer trend, which is built-in ergonomics that kind of dictate your grip. It's still comfortable in a complete grip, but it kind of, again, has that specific contouring for your hand to hold it a certain way. And the knife is flat and tall with lots of choils. Between these two handles, the Bacall actually has deeper, more secure choils and also some jimping, which the Yojimbo doesn't have. You can actually see the jimping on the Bacall is actually very interesting looking. They look like little spikes, but they don't hurt. On camera, it looks actually very straight across. It does have a slight curve. I would just perhaps call it like a hybrid Warncliffe Hawkbill. But it will perform slash cuts better because it does grab the material. But the Yojimbo 2 utilizes a Warncliffe, which, though not as maybe tactically focused as the other blade, it will still make deep cuts because of the hollow grind, which naturally helps it not shoulder depending on the angle you're cutting at, especially for just shallow cuts. For both, they don't really display a sort of stabbing blade shape, but I think if you were to hold these side by side, the Bacall is going to feel more sturdy for that type of technique because of the thicker tip and the full flat grind. Now this review is only looking at these two knives and their ability to perform their marketed role, which is self-defense. Deploying a folio knife happens either before there's a physical conflict or during the actual conflict. If it's before, then both can be done, no problem, you know, but I will say that the Yojimbo has always had that hole being obstructed, and the Bacall feels more natural again because of that more open spacing. But don't forget, the Bacall does have the wave, so if a person can set it up, that's going to be faster. But deploying during the actual conflict, then we go back to the ergonomics of the Yojimbo. Again, where the tail makes it a little bit less than preferable for gripping and extracting. But once out, it may be more easy to gravity shake the Yojimbo. And this is where the Bacall design starts to get more, I would say, serious for the purpose of self-defense. In a fight, you're not always in control of which hand is free. If you look at the pocket clip positions of the Yojimbo 2 and imagine tip down, you're either going to grab it overhand or underhand. And all these descriptions here, that's how it works. So, say overhand, the only option might be to spider drop it, but then that doesn't work because you're going to cut yourself, unless you're taking a risk. Underhand, and then you're just going to normal open it. And you have your sort of two options, or just basically finger deployment. Tip up, you get your over and you have your normal thumb grip, or maybe a gravity shake, an index. But under, if you grab it this way, you have nothing. This isn't one of those knives you can deploy in any of those ways. Tip down, reversed. Again, this is all showing the right pocket. Over, you got nothing. Maybe a gravity shake. Okay, you could do that. So I'll give it that. Over with a reverse, and you don't really have anything. You actually have to turn it. But that's, again, not so bad. You can just practice that, rotating it. If you use your opposite hand on the Yojimbo, again, now we have it set up for tip down. If you go from this direction, you don't really have anything unless you rotate it and open. If you have it for tip up, you go this way, you can perhaps gravity shake it. Tip up like this, you grab it, you're gonna have to rotate, try to flick it open, gravity shake it. Tip down like this, you go to grab it, and you pull it out, normal opening. But in all those ways, you can see it's pretty much what's saving you is the gravity shake. Looking at the Pakal, if you situate it for forward deployment, pull it forward and out, and that's with the underhand, it just pulls out. Overhand though, you're just gonna rotate in your hand, normal deployment. If you situate for a rearward deployment, meaning the clip switches on this side of the right pocket, overhand, pull is normal. If it's underhand, then it, perhaps you can see where that's not so good. With the call, if you have it set for forward deployment, you reach over with the left, your opposite hand, you grab it, and again, you're kind of stuck in this position. If it's situated and the pocket's on the other side, and for rearward deployment, you grab it, you can rearward deploy it. The one thing, though, that all this isn't showing is that the Pakal, in all those times where you're stuck, for example, it's like this grip, or like this, that wave can be caught after the fact. And so it doesn't really matter how, because let's say it's your opposite hand, you have it situated this way, go and just pull it on your pant leg, your other pant leg, or the other person. Same thing here. If you pull it out this way, just go and twist it and just deploy it. And this knife is situated, so it doesn't really matter how you hold it. There is a grip for every hand position. You can see how that, even that stainless wave kind of helps. Same thing for the Pakal when you're using your primary hand. If you're going to deploy it forward, you know, from an underhand, that works. Overhand didn't work. You just twist it, now wave it. Same thing now if you're situating for a rearward deployment, of course that works. Underhand, again, just turn it, wave it after the fact. And it's also more like a serious traditional fine knife that's double-sided and ambidextrous. Meaning it doesn't really matter how you're holding it, especially I guess if you're only going for a stabbing maneuver. This knife has a grip position for whatever you're doing. So that gives you a lot of options to practice. But again, I'll say with the Yojimbo 2, it's really breaking in that detent and mastering that gravity shake technique, which will help it a lot. And obviously for fine purposes, both knives will do the cutting, especially since we're just talking about against soft tissue and with lots of force. But I will say that it feels psychologically more accommodating to stab with the Pakal, just because the tip tapers down to a little bit more of a narrow point right at the end. So you can kind of see that, like it just seems a little more comfortable to do that with the Pakal. So my final thoughts are, I recommend the Yojimbo 2 and still do because I know how strong and reliable the compression lock is, and also how much the structural design of the knife can handle, meaning the hardware and also the build quality and the blade. And if you're thinking also for perhaps EDC and utility, this will be a easy knife to maintain with durable hardware you can work on. But after handling the Pakal, it does seem that in some ways it has the edge for self-defense, perhaps the wiser choice. And that's mostly to do with the way the Pakal addresses all the aspects of using a folding knife in a confrontation. Lock strength on the Pakal I can't say much about without testing, but a steel ball lock with such a strong spring should be very effective, similar to how the Axis lock works. The Yojimbo 2 is more of a straightforward knife that's tough, and someone that is determined can make quality count over quantity, but that's really how to differentiate these two. The Pakal offers more variety of techniques, which equals more options in real life, and in the long run, it will provide more depth to your training. If a person modifies the Yojimbo 2, that would greatly improve its performance. And otherwise, though, if they're willing to carry tip down, then there is more of a bulk to grab, which kind of reduces that limitation, that weakness of this tapered tail end. So if a person is again willing to master gravity shaking, you will still be able to very capably defend yourself with your Yojimbo 2. Using a folder in a self-defense situation requires practice. So thank you for watching. Please visit my website for written reviews, and also stay tuned for more 5-point reviews, tackle knife discussions, and whatever else I can do to contribute. Thank you.